Hi guys, we are back with a new video. So what we have here is a glass etching process. So today we are going to give you a brief explanation about how a glass etching process is done. So by use of a glass cutter, divide the glass into two halves. After cutting the glass, place the glass on the table and cut it by the use of a diamond glass cutter. These glass cutters are different from normal cutters. These cutters use diamond as a tip to cut the glass. After cutting the glass, remove the excess part or remove the unwanted part of the glass. Remove it gently. Try not to break the original piece. After removing it, this is a resist. Place the resist or apply the resist to the glass. A resist is a two-layered. One is an adhesive layer and another is a silicone layer. A layer may be different according to the type of work. So by using a flat wide plastic squeeze, apply the resist to the glass. It ensures that the resist goes down without trapping bubbles. After that, remove the excess part. And do the same on the other side of the glass. So you have to be very careful when applying the resist. After that, cut the excess resist. And the next step, draw the pattern or the design. Sometimes we use stencils or pre-planned designs. So now we are not using a stencils. So he was drawing some kind of painting. I think it is a flower. Those are leaves. You need to be so artistic for doing this kind of work. If you are not that good type of artist, you can have patterns, different types of patterns, different types of beautiful images. But I think he's a very good artist. You can see it, how he was doing that work, how he was drawing. You can see it. It's really very good. So after completing the drawing, you need to take a cutter and peel the inner resist. I mean peel the resist which need to be sandblasted. I will show you how a sandblasting is done in a few minutes. Peel the resist gently because this is the most important part for getting a beautiful image. So after peeling the resist, the next step is a sandblasting. After completing the peeling process, the next stage is a sandblasting. So we have two types of sandblasters, Simfon and pressure blasters. So what he was using is a pressure blaster. So the type of material that we are using for a sandblaster is a silicon carbide. The reason why we are using a sandblasting process because it gives a white milky shape for the glass. Sandblasting is a very dangerous process because we are using a very high pressure sand or sand like material. So after the sandblasting, so now we are cutting the outer side of the image. We will let you know why we are cutting the outer side of the image. You will see in a few minutes. We have to cut it very gently and very carefully. Draw the outer boundaries and peel it gently. The image which we wanted should be covered with the resist because now we are going for a real etching process. So we are using some kind of black material. They are applying all over the glass. So etching is a process where you use an acid type of material. So what they are doing, they are pouring the acid on the glass. So after that, after pouring the acid on the glass, wait for 15 to 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, peel the outer edge of the glass. Drain all the acid. You can collect it. After that, rinse it with enough water. So peel the resist. The reason why we are using the acid because it melts the glass. You can see it. So this is the reason why we use the acid. So you can see there, it melted the surface of the glass, and you can also see why we use that black material. So this is the stage where we use painting stuff. So what he was doing, he is painting the glass by the help of a paint gun. He is using green paint for leaves. He is painting all the leaves with green. Now he is painting the flower. I think it is a mixture of red and brown. And this is another flower, and he is painting with another color. I think it is blue. I think the process, it is completed. I think this is the last stage of the process. What a eye-catching, splendid, pleasant, excellent design. So guys, this is our video about glass etching process. I think you have enjoyed every moment of it. So this is the end of our video, and we will be coming back with a new video. Until then, this is me signing off. See you guys.